Ah, awesome, Pali. Now, there's a saying that goes, if your dreams don't scare you, you aren't dreaming big enough. Well, Eternal Africa is a musician whose career took a long time to blossom up until he started believing that he was amongst the best in his field. The producer, songwriter and performing artist has worked on almost all of the biggest soundtracks and songs that you hear on your radio and television today. And right now, he joins us in the loft to share his inspiring journey. But first, let's have a look at some of the tracks that he's produced that earned him a spot amongst the best in the game.
I see you break it down, let me see you break it down. I see you break it down, break it down, break it down.
Hello, hello, baby. How do you do, baby? I miss you too. Show you love, give you love, oh yeah. I put it on my mama, yeah. I swear I'll never lie, oh yeah. I'll never break your heart, oh yeah.
If you make me nice, I'll be your man.
Africa, welcome to Afternoon Express.
Thanks.
Basically, you are South Africa's Pharrell Williams because you are the man behind all of the songs that we hear on radio these days.
Yeah, it happens to be.
I read that you said that your career took a long time before it actually bolstered because you just refused to work with mediocre people because you thought that it would stifle your talent. I've never read truer words before in my life, and I can agree with you for so much. So how do you pick and choose the people that you work with?
First of all, you must be able to love. Yeah. Without love, I can't work with you.
Exactly.
So I was able to spot out my current team now and their ability to love who they're working with.
Yeah.
So because of that, I was able to work with this current team.
That is amazing. Now, you write and you produce all of these incredible songs.
Yeah.
How does it work with your artists that you work? Do you write songs particularly for them, or do you just have like this wealth of music and then they pick and choose what they want? Or do you write and produce specifically to each artist?
It happens in both ways.
Yeah.
I spend time to create music, then clients could come. Hey, Eternal, play me some beats. I play you beats and you choose from. Or you say, Eternal Africa, let's start from the scratch. So I develop your product for you.
Yeah. It's beautiful, and you are so hugely talented. Let's speak about you now, because now you've got your own brand. Where does the name Eternal Africa come from, and why did you choose that?
You see, Africa is blessed with all kinds of natural resources.
Yeah.
The potential in Africa is just too much. And it feeds a lot of people outside Africa because our product is exported.
Yeah.
And for this fact, it means the products from Africa has an eternal value.
Yeah.
From generation to generation to generation, you will use a product from Africa, whether it's petrol, you know, name it.
Yeah.
So the name Eternal Africa came into existence. So I want to express this potential through music and arts. Yeah, that's it.
When did you develop your love of music? Because what I absolutely love about you is that you are a person who is curious about everything in life. Like, you were, like, you studied Christianity, but you also understood voodoo too, so that you understand how everything works.
Yeah.
So where did your passion for music come from?
It all started from childhood. I grew up in an environment of strong musical, traditional musical influence.
Mm.
So I picked up interest there, then also the church. I also grew up in the church and mastered their sound.
Yeah.
So merged everything together. It gave me a good solid background and foundation.
What's your favorite kind of music to listen to? Because I've noticed in the music that you produce, you've got like a quite Afrocentric sound, and then you also do my favorite word, gnom. Did I say it right?
I've been trying to pronounce that word for a long time.
It is a hard word to say,
yeah,
but it's one of my favorite words. So you definitely go across so many kind of different genres. So what kind of music do you like to listen to? What's your favorite?
I listen to all kinds of music.
Yeah.
So Because it makes me strong and solid in my art. You cannot focus. For you to be a super producer, you must be able to listen to all kinds of genre of music and practice them.
Yeah.
You learn them, you practice them, then you can meet anyone in the world and give a good product.
And you are a good producer also because you're so thoughtful. You understand the feeling and the meaning behind words and the impact of sound. So I really, really love the concept of your song No Fear, especially because of where you've got all of the clips of people experiencing moments in their lives when they're not experiencing fear. What gives you no fear? And what was the moment in your life when you were the scaredest, where you were the most fearful?
What gives me no fear? I think, for a very long time, I've been able to study love.
Yeah.
I've been practicing love, you know, because my background...
I like practicing love too.
So when you practice love, I think you have a no fear mentality.
It is good to love. Love is the most important thing in the world.
Yeah, because when they say there's danger, you'll be asking, how is it dangerous?
But you only get to that place once you've experienced true fear. So what was that moment in your life when you literally thought, am I going to live through this?
Okay, I think when I had an accident, my car somersaulted thrice.
You don't have good luck with cars. I heard you were hit by a car as well when you were in school.
So I think when I somersaulted thrice, I thought it's going to be over. But I found myself out of the car. Then I said, nothing happened to me, not even a scratch.
Really?
And I somersaulted thrice and hit the fence, you know? And I came out alive. I said, wow, if I can survive this... Why should I be afraid of anything?
You definitely have a guardian angel. Yeah. So why the song No Fear? What was your inspiration behind that?
Okay, if you look at Africa now, there's a lot of challenge. There's tension everywhere. Yeah. So I'm trying to inspire my brothers and sisters around Africa. No fear. Have a no fear mentality. And you know what? When you have a no fear mentality, you're able to make right choices. Because when you're scared, you can't make a good choice. So I'm trying to tell my brothers and sisters around Africa, no fear, just go for it. Yeah. Try your best, keep pushing, and you'll make it.
Well, thank you so much for being here today.
Thank you very much.
Be performing for us a little bit later.
I can't wait.
But we are so inspired by you. You are just doing such incredible work. So thank you for being you.
Thanks for having me again.
So we are crossing over now to the 5FM studio to tune in with the Tabudi Show. Our dearest Pali is standing by as radio show host Tande Tabudi is about to call the last winner of the 100,000 Rand grand prize for the Shop Manhattan style competition. So Pali, so there must be lots of excitement in the studio as someone's day is literally about to be made.